y'all. Come on, be great. Be great. Come on. Here we go. Time to finish.
Go. Stop. Do it back inside again.
This is Unsighted with Laniesha David, all things sports related, from athletes to entertainers. Hello, 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 and welcome back into the podcast where dreamers just like you and I bare their souls. Today's guest on the podcast is Jamil Merrell. Jamil Merrell is a former Scarlet Knight and now the director of performance at Alpha Training based out of Newark, Delaware. Jamil and I, we had a dope conversation. Like, he's the true definition of hard work and determination, and you'll see what I mean. And we just talk. We talk about life. We speak a little bit about the Michael Bennett situation, but most importantly, what I took from our conversation is God, family, and football, in that order. Be sure to like and subscribe to Unsighted with Laniesha David on iTunes, SoundCloud, and Google Play. Please leave a review. All feedback is welcome. But for now, sit back and relax. Jamil Merrell, y'all. Jamil Merrell. All right, so when I get up in the morning and the first thing I do is I hop on the internet and I see what's going on in the world. Then I hop on NFL Mobile and I see what's going on in the football world. And then I hop on Instagram, and you're probably always the first person on my Instagram story. 6:30, 7:30, 8 o'clock in the morning, and I'm like, yo, I need to get out of bed. Like, Mill in the gym, like. So you are definitely an inspiration to me, so thank you so much for coming on the show.
That.
No problem.
Appreciate that. Really do. I really do.
Okay, so what's your nickname?
Nehemiah.
Nehemiah?
Nehemiah.
Oh, I was not expecting that.
I don't know. I guess because it's my middle name, actually. But
okay.
People like it. I mean, I don't know why, but if I had to say another name, it would be Fathead.
Fathead.
And people get that from my dad. My dad been calling me that ever since I was a little boy. And then I guess people grasped onto it. So if I had to say it, it'd definitely be Fathead.
Fathead.
I mean, I had nice chubby cheeks when I was little, so you know, yeah. My dad went and rolled with it, so Fathead if I had to say one.
Fathead. And Nehemiah sounds like a prophet. Like you
yes,
out there.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
So
people say Nehemiah because that's what they get from you. Mm. Got you. Mm. So I also seen your Instagram story. Are you about to have a baby?
Yes, I am.
Oh my
yes,
gosh, I congratulations. I wasn't sure.
Big blessing.
Yes.
Big blessing.
Boy or girl?
Boy.
Okay.
Another Jamil Merrell.
Okay. All right.
Other me.
So do I hear wedding bells soon? Or?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. I mean, they're starting to put the pressure on me now.
Okay.
But I mean, definitely. I'm definitely going to marry the girl of my dreams right now, my high school sweetheart Aisha Noel. So yeah, I definitely see that in the near future. But I mean, yeah, I'm just gonna end it at that.
Okay, shout out to Aisha. Okay.
Yeah.
Did you hear about the whole Michael Bennett situation going on right now?
I heard some of it. I try to stay away from the news and all that bad energy, but negative energy. But I mean, I heard a little bit of. I ain't heard.
Heard too much about it. Okay. All right. So you heard that he would allegedly pushed a 60-year-old paraplegic.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
I don't know. If I could just say, like, the media, I'm not really a media guy just because of the fact that the media takes things and spins it 360.
Absolutely.
More. So to just say, have I heard about something? It's just a little beyond me because it you don't know what the truth is.
Exactly.
Now, knowing Michael Bennett and the way he is, I mean, pretty sure something happened. But at the end of the day, it ain't got to do with me, so I really
exactly.
don't touch bases with it.
Got you.
Got you. So do you find it just a little bit ironic that they say they don't have any footage, number one, and number two, he's getting ready to drop a book called Things That Make White People Uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. And now he's getting attacked.
Which doesn't make the situation okay.
Any better. Right. Mm-hmm. All right. So I'm going to hop right into it. So, Jamil, take me back to high school. Mm-hmm. If I asked you, if I knew you back in high school and I asked you, what did you want to be when you grow up? What would be your answer?
I would say NFL draft pick.
Okay.
It's funny because people say they want to go to the NFL and all that and follow their dreams, but it's one thing to say it and it's one thing to live it. Like, I've been playing football since the age of 4, me and my brother. So that was my life. Like, that's what I do. I mean, my dad would say, this is your job, and that's what we called it, our job. We got up every day and went to work, put the work in the mornings before school since freshman year, me and my brother. So I would really say being in the NFL and nothing else. Honestly, nothing else. There was no backup plan, but because that's just what it was. That was life at the time.
Got you. So you speak on your dad a couple times since we first started talking. You guys have a good relationship?
Yeah, that's my partner. That's my man. Okay. The true definition of love is him.
Okay.
And having your back and all that, it doesn't compare.
So why football out of all sports?
I'm a physical guy. I like to beat up on people. And okay. I ain't trying to get locked up for it, so what's the next best thing? And that's football. So I like the physicality of it and being with your boys, going to war with your boys, you know, having to be accountable in a situation, making big plays and all that. That's what I always strive for, and also just winning, you know, having that feeling of winning, being successful, you know, battling for 2 hours, coming out victorious, you know. That's what I enjoy about it.
Okay, and where are you at with that now?
I honestly think I'm done football.
Okay.
I'm currently training right now, training all types of athletes, lacrosse, mm-hmm. football players, baseball players. It's kind of like the same thing to me because I'm still in the sports field, mm-hmm. but it's not the same thing as strapping on the pads and all that, but I think I've come to an agreement with myself and understanding that football doesn't last forever.
Okay.
You know, at some point in time it does end, and hearing that growing up and having to understand that football does end someday, that would just go out of one ear and out the other. So to have it happen to me, and I mean, I'm a God-believing man, so I believe it was my calling that, yeah, it's over for you. So, I mean, I've come to grips with it now, but it wasn't easy. It definitely wasn't easy.
So would you say that was the first detrimental no that you had in your life?
I would say so, yes. Besides losing my older brother, I would say yes.
Okay. And walk me through that pain and tell me how you overcame it.
Solitude, finding my, getting closer to God. I being in that lifestyle, the football lifestyle, college lifestyle, you really don't have to go searching for anything. Everything is given to you. So to have the NFL out my life, football out my life. I mean, I was still playing football, but it wasn't the same as 11-on-11 or anything closer to the NFL. Mm-hmm. So to have that taken away, it was tough. I mean, I really would have to say solitude, just finding peace, quietness, reading the Bible, you know, just stuff like that.
Talk to me about Alpha Training.
It's owned by Jake, a good friend of mine. We came, another person, Jerome.
Okay.
He went to Syracuse, good friend of mine also.
So it's a it's a group thing.
Yeah, I would say a group thing.
Okay.
Alpha Training.
Okay.
Just got a bout and all that. I don't know if you can see, but I'm actually here now.
Okay.
I ain't gonna mess with it, but just a nice little athlete for all types of athletes. Excuse me. In a Newark, Delaware. You know, Delaware doesn't have anything that's close to Alpha Training, so to have it here in Delaware is a big thing because athletes don't really have a place to train. I mean, yeah, they got the turf field outside, but they don't have the indoor facility that they can always come to no matter what the season is, no matter what they're doing. We're always open. So we're just trying to give athletes a place where they can have some fun and also get better.
Okay. Okay. So when you wake up in the morning and you look yourself in the mirror, tell me, what is that one thing you just couldn't live without?
Couldn't live without. Couldn't live without.
That one thing that.
I would say my family. I can't live without my family.
Family?
I would honestly say my family. I mean, everything else is interchangeable, but my family, can't nobody compare it to them. You know, my twin brother, can't nobody compare it to him. If I'm gonna have you in my life, you gotta be closer to either my brother or my father, and don't many people come close to them, so that's I can't live without them.
Okay, I didn't know you had a twin brother.
Yeah, I do, twin brother Jamil Merrell.
Okay, now most people would say you've made it, and you know, this is it for you, this is your calling. But for you, is this the end?
Oh, definitely not. Definitely not. I have a lot of blessings coming my way right now with obviously athletic training and also football. I mean, I had the opportunity when I was out in Colorado, I had the opportunity to coach for the Colorado Crush, the defensive line. I injured my ankle, so they let me on the coaching staff. So I had that opportunity, and it really, like, it was the next best thing to playing football, like sitting up there in the booth and seeing my guys do what I told them in practice and apply it on the field was just the next best thing. So I'm sitting there, and I realized that as I was sitting up there, I realized the game felt like it lasted like 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, all right, like, that's that good feeling. Like, all right, maybe this the next thing, coaching.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, and I think that's just God. That's just God, because, I mean, things don't happen like that. Arena football game usually lasts about what, hour and a half, 2 hours, close to the same thing as football. But for me to sit there and not be playing and still get the joy and the passion of coaching somebody else and coming out the game and, I mean, excuse me, going into halftime and see them immediately look at me for help was just like, man, this is the next thing for me. And it also, it released that void of playing football. So I really don't, when I think about football, I really don't think about me necessarily. I think about the next best thing, and that's coaching.
Got you. And have you ever done any other coaching?
No, I haven't.
Okay.
I haven't. But okay. I mean, being around the game so long and playing it for so long that, I mean, there's really, obviously there's always stuff I can learn, but I know so much. It's like, why not?
If you ever had the chance to play football again, would you?
Yes. Oh, yes. I have arena teams call me all the time, and I'm just like, yeah, I think I'm done. I think I'm done. And they always say, well, one guy said, man, I'm sorry to hear that. And it's just like, damn, is he telling me that, man, you can still do it? And I know for sure, for a fact, that I can still do it. And when I sit here and train these, kids, it's just like, And I put my hand down to demonstrate what I want them to do. It's just like, all right, here we go again. Like, I get that feeling, like, go get it, you know? So I definitely feel as though I can still play the game. But, you know, you just know when you know sometimes, you know? And then the fact of the matter that the NFL is more so a business rather than just showing up and playing, You know, it's not like, it's nothing like high school. It's more so a business. So, and I'm really not a guy that's just going to show up to a place and fake the funk like it's this way when really it's this way. I just want to show up and play football. I'm not here to fake smile on your face or fake have a conversation with you. I'm just here to play football. So, I mean, but yeah.
Yeah.
That's about it.
Well, me personally, I think I'm a good judge of character. And that's why I reached out to you. I definitely feel your passion, and I definitely believe in you. So definitely, definitely keep in touch and let me know what you got going on. When I hear your Instagram stories, I literally, like, I'll get goosebumps. When you're like, no, seriously, when you're like, come on, come on, keep going. Like, you sound, you are a coach to me in my eyes. Like, you're Coach Mill Morrell. So what is something about you that people don't know?
People don't know?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I hope a lot. I don't want everybody to know everything about me, but...
Gotta leave a little bit of mystery.
I really don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I can really ask that. People, I think they know enough that they should know. But that's about it. But what they don't know, I don't know how to answer that.
No? Not gonna let me into no secrets?
Nah, no secrets. Right. I don't think I have any secrets, but nah, no secrets over here.
Okay.
Everybody know I play football. Everybody, you know. Delaware is such a small state that everybody know everybody. So, I mean, I think they know what they need to know and should know, and that's about it.
Okay. All right, so my last question for you is, what is some advice you would give someone like yourself, a dreamer or a visionary, who is scared to start somewhere or maybe even start over?
I would say just keep going. I mean, keep failing. Keep failing and keep going no matter what it is you're doing, you're trying to do. I say touch as many things as possible. And if you get the sense of, oh, this ain't it, or this is it, then listen to your instincts. I mean, people tend to overthink things a lot when it's not as bad as it seems, or it's not as good as it seems all the time. So just keep it going. Follow your passion. Everybody was put on this earth to do something. Like, everybody's good at something. So just to say that, go what you're good at. I mean, and if you're good at learning, go find something that you can learn and apply it, you know? So I would just say, don't worry about the bad things. Just stay positive, because, I mean, if you stay positive, can't nobody knock you off the road. I mean, positive takes care of itself. A negative situation to a negative situation can only bring a negative situation. You put positive with negative, half the time, if you stay positive, a positive is going to come out of that situation. So I would just say stay positive. Keep failing. And at the end of the day, just keep giving it your all. And positive things can only happen in your life.
Okay.
Yep, so.
All right, Jamil. Cool. So thank you so much for coming on the show. Tell everybody where they can find you at on social media.
Okay, you can find me on Instagram at Mill_Merrell, Facebook Jamil Merrell, and that's about it.
Okay.
That's about it. If you're a Delaware listener, get the Alpha. We got the best of the best trainers, all that, you know. And just to the people, keep grinding, keep getting it, stay positive.
Okay, Jamil. Again, thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
And that was Jamil Merrell, y'all. Now do you guys see what I mean? Y'all heard it here first. Jamil said fail and keep failing and give it your all until you win. But stay positive, because when you stay positive, only positive things can come into your life. Next time, Jamil, I am definitely going to get some secrets out of you. But if you guys are ever in the Delaware area and you are looking to train with the best of the best, Alpha Training is for you. Thank you guys so much for listening. I truly appreciate it. And if you haven't already, please leave a review And be sure to like and subscribe to Unsighted with Laniesha David on iTunes, SoundCloud, and Google Play. Follow my journey, y'all. I'm out.
Remind me not to lose my soul. Ooh, but that's when the rain gets to falling. It's coming down on me. Feels like the weight of the world was blind, but now.